Dalvin Jones here with the Park Tool Company for Tech Tuesday.
Truman here with the seals.
The seals? Yes, the seals. Because the seals are the heart of the hydraulic disc brake, and it's important to maintain your heart. So to get everyone on the same page, let's talk about how the magic happens riding down the trail. We want to slow our wheel by slowing our rotor. So we're going down the trail, and here comes a tree. Oh, well, we avoided it. Pads move in. Pads
move back.
That's right, and the moving back is going to be the important part. So we saw the fluid come in here, but we got to look inside to see what the magic is. Break that in half for us. Nice. So we've taken a break, sliced it to see the fun inside. What do we have?
We've got ourselves, the white piece here is a piston.
Mm-hmm. It's traveling inside. It's not an O-ring, it's a square ring.
Yeah.
That's an important thing. It's sitting down inside what is called the gland. So this channel here is gonna allow some motion of our seal.
Yeah, and how that motion kind of works, so my hand is gonna be the piston moving in the bore here. This is gonna be the seal. As the piston moves, advances forward, the seal is going to flex. That flex allows the seal to actually pull the piston back.
Mm-hmm.
So it's flexing forward and then pulling it back. And we're calling it
rollback. That's right.
So that's called rollback. This is advancing. And mm-hmm. then as your pads thin, your piston needs to advance further.
Mm-hmm.
So your seal will reach its maximum amount of flex and then the piston will slip and it'll take up the amount needed for the wear of the pad.
That's right. And all of this braking and all of this riding has gotten lots and lots of crud on it. Eventually, we're gonna put some new pads on this bike. We're gonna first step, take out the old pads. We wanna push the pistons back home, get back home through our seals. That's the dangerous part.
So this is all dirty.
Yeah.
We don't wanna push it all back.
Don't feed your seals junk. Let's clean it up. We'll show them what to do. Seems like, Truman, you pulled the wheel out of here.
Yeah.
I guess that's a start. And I got the cleaning supplies. We have cotton swabs, clean ones. Some DOT fluid for our DOT friends. Mineral fluid for our mineral fluid friends. Alcohol and a clean rag.
All right, let's jump right into it, Calvin.
Okay.
Pull the clip.
Bam.
We got a little screw. Boom.
Put down. Now inside, we have our pistons, but we need to bring them into the center. We do that by carefully pulling. I'm gonna start pulling up here.
All right,
and
let's see it.
He's gonna watch.
Keep her coming, keep her coming. Push, push, push. Keep going. Couple more pumps. All right, let's just leave it there. So let's clean this side first, and then we'll push that one back and clean the other
side. Why can't I keep going more?
Well, you don't wanna go any more because if you go too far, the piston will push out. And there's fluid all over the floor.
Tears on the floor. So do not let the pistons fall out.
All right.
Fluid?
Nope.
Not this
is a
break.
Mineral-based system, so we're gonna use mineral
fluid.
There
we go.
Fluid. Reach in here. Scrub, 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 scrub. Scrub the top.
360, looking for all the way around.
You can kind of feel some dirt on there.
Yeah, what's been in your ear, Truman?
Yeah, you never know. A lot of things get in there.
Yeah.
I'm gonna push this piston back a little in this case.
Okay, I'm relieving the pressure up above. One piston's clean, so Truman, you hold that side in, and we'll bring the other one out carefully and slowly.
All right, keep pulling.
Okay, I'm not watching, I'm just gonna keep pulling. You tell me when.
All right, right there. Keep pressure on it, fresh fluid. Bottom, top, sides, 360 degrees of cleaning. Push it back.
Back into the body.
Now let's pull the lever a couple more times. Move it out. Oh, right there. All right, push it back in. Push this side back in. Try again. Pull the lever. That one's really lazy. So this inner piston is not moving nearly as much as this outer piston. So what we're doing here is we're exercising that inner piston so that it'll move the same amount.
Lazy seal.
Yep, it's a lazy harbor seal. All right, keep exercising. I'm gonna push this piston back in. Push this piston back in. Keep going. All right, there we go, that should be good. We'll push these back in. Now, we're gonna clean with some alcohol. And the alcohol is gonna keep, it's gonna clean off all of that residual oil.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure it doesn't contaminate your pads.
There we are.
Okay, now that we have happy caliper seals, we can now reassemble our pads and caliper and put our wheel back in, and we're gonna be happier riders because we have happier seals.
You will find sometimes that one piston seems to be moving more than not quite symmetrical. That's because the seals, we have one a little bit lazy, one a little more active. No worries, simply move the caliper accordingly. Let the seals be where they want to be.
Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoy Tech Tuesdays, check out our Repair Help video library, which has detailed guides to a wide variety of common bike maintenance procedures. And of course, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest videos from Park Tool.